in the name of Jesus. We will bury Saul. The purpose of coming in the presence of God is to meet with God. The purpose of serving Him is to be blessed. And one of the ways to be blessed is to hear from Him. God, speak to me in the name of Jesus. Let me hear from you. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
That is shabby. Amen. In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
Father God, we thank you because you are alone and you are God, because you are going to speak this moment. Be glorified in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
God, we want our service to be of blessing. Every soul that partake in the service should rejoice forever and remember this moment for good in their lives. Father, do so in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Because you don't want us to remain in the bondage of Satan. That is why you always speak. That's him that says, as the Lord Most High speak to his people then, so shall he speak today.
Amen.
He says, just obey. God, we pray for the spirit of obedience. The spirit to enable our ears to open and to listen to the word and to obey. Give us in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let us be blessed.
Amen.
In Jesus' name we pray.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. I want to welcome you and bless you today by the grace of God. And I pray that the Lord is going to meet you in this short moment that we have. Though it offends some people when you say that we are having a limited or short time to preach. They say it's an offense that you don't, when it comes to singing, you have time. When it comes to contribution of money, you have time. When it comes to prayer, you have time. But when it comes to the word of God, you say you don't have time. But it's not how long, it's how well, it's how impacting. Sometimes time may not permit us, but no matter how short, it should be impactful. What matters most is God to speak to his people. And this moment, every spirit that wants your spirit to wander away, that wants you not to hear from God, shall be removed this moment in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Ephesians chapter 6, verses 10 to 12. Ephesians 6, 10 to 12. That is what we read. I'm going to read most of time. Finally, be strong in the Lord and in his mighty power. Put on the full armor of God so that you can take your stand against the devil's scheme. For our struggle is not against flesh and blood, but against the rulers and against the authorities, against the power of this dark world, and against the spiritual force of evil in the heavenly realm. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
This moment we are going to listen to the word of God, which titled, Defeating the One That Defeats You. Defeating the One That Defeats You. The Paul Apostle admonish and encourage the Ephesians that don't fight the right battle in the wrong way. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Don't fight the right battle in the wrong way. Defeating the one that defeats you. And this is also applicable to every one of us as Christians, as a believer of God, as a follower of Christ. Are you with me?
Yes.
As a follower of Christ, it's also applicable because this day and age, we fight spiritual battle with physical weapon. That is what Paul want the Ephesians to understand. That you don't, if anybody call themselves anything, you don't fight them with physical weapon. Because they are not the one you are fighting against. During this week, one of the major presenters on ITV declared himself as, I don't want to mention it, Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
And he's one of the most respected presenter. Hallelujah. So now people begin to reason with him, compare with him. Now this is what I'm saying. Whatever he calls himself, you are not going to, because you're a Christian, because you're against his idea, does not mean that you are going to pick up weapon against him. That is what Paul is talking here. That you are not fighting against human. You are not fighting against man who call himself a woman. You are not fighting against woman who says she's no longer a woman. She wants to be identified as man. But what he's telling you is that you are fighting against spirits. Hallelujah. The spirit that goes about fooling people. The device of Satan. These are the areas which Christians, which followers of Christ are missing the battle. These are the areas which we are missing the battle. That is why the battle seems difficult to be fought. So Paul observed this in lifetime or the process of worship of the Ephesians. Then he quickly bring their knowledge to it. That you are not going to go about fighting those who are not Christians. You are not going to go about taking sword, taking weapons, killing those who don't share your idea. Because it is not their fault that they share your idea. It means there is a force, there is a power, there is a spirit working somewhere. And that is where you are supposed to focus your battle. Because of time, who is the one that defeat us? Who are we fighting against? As Paul advised, he said, you are fighting against Satan and his agents. Let's read the book of 1 Peter chapter 5, verse 8. 1 Peter 5, 8. I don't want to waste time, but I want you to be blessed by God. 1 Peter 5, 8. Yes. Be self-controlled and alert. This thing said, be self-controlled and alert. Your enemies, the devil, prowl around like a roaring lion, looking for someone to devour. So the Bible tells you that the one that defeats you is Satan. And that is what Paul also mentioned in verse Ephesians 6:12, which says, let me see other, which says, for our struggle is not against flesh and blood. Some people go to the point of piercing themselves. They piece themselves because they think that it is their body, it is their flesh and blood that push them to sin. So they condemn themselves to death. They believe that if I die now, then there will be peace in the world. Your death doesn't take an inch out of the chaos in this world because you are contributing nothing. The spirit that's still operating before Jesus was born is still operating up to now. People has been recognizing themselves as whatever they want to recognize themselves to be. Even since the day of the Bible, even since the word has since human begin to grow. If it's not so, why would God be so fierce? Be so rage against Sodom and Gomorrah. What do you think Sodom and Gomorrah practice? So people have been going against God. They have been going against AI. They have been going against morality. So that's why it tells you that you are not wrestling against your flesh. You are not wrestling against your blood. But you are wrestling against spirits. He said, but against rulers, against the authorities, against the power of this dark world, and against the spiritual force of evil in heavenly realms. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You are wrestling against. These are the things that strategically defeat us. And today the Lord is giving you authority to defeat them in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Let's quickly observe the weapon they use. The weapon they use, the ammunition, the weapon they use against us, the weapon they use against people of the world. Number one is Adamic nature. Adamic nature. Romans chapter 8:9. Romans 8:9. I want us to read, but I want you to be alert while opening your Bible so that you will not waste time. Romans 8:9. It says, you, however, are controlled not by the sinful nature but by the Spirit. If the Spirit of God lives in you, and if anyone does not have the Spirit of Christ, he does not belong to Christ. We fight battle against Adamic nature. Things that are not right, but our body wants. Then we will come and introduce it. In the Garden of Eden, what happened? Satan came and said, how are you, Madam Eve? Are you sure God said you should not eat any? That's how it started. God said you should not eat any of this fruit. That is how they come to you as well and say, does your pastor, does your church teach you to pick up weapon or to have hatred mind against certain people? No, they will come with that general question. If that is not taken, then you want to explain. Whereas they are not there to explain. They are not there to listen to your explanation. But they are really working hard to make sure that they convince you that you must listen to your body. We live in an era where everybody wants to follow their mind. Everybody wants to please themselves. When you say don't do it, they'll say no, you are breaching my rights. I can dress the way I like. I can speak the way I like. I can drink the way I like. I can smoke the way I like. I can party the way I like. But they will say don't stop me. But when the repercussion comes, they will want you to consider with them. They want you to pity them. Hey, sorry. Is it hot? You can't eat your cannabis. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
They want to please themselves. At the same time, when the repercussion comes, they want to be saying, hey, sorry, is it hot? Yeah. How does it happen? I understand you. I don't know how they call it. Hallelujah. If someone sleep, I will stand you up. Post-traumatic stress. How do they call it? Hallelujah. Somebody will say, let me eat what I like. And when he becomes obese, and he will not want the doctor to say that he's fat or he's obese, he will say that he makes me feel as if it was myself. When they tell you, eat healthy, live healthy, you will say no. They tell you, don't smoke, stop smoking. You say no, it's my right. I have right to smoke. I have right to live my life. It's my civil right. Don't stop me. I pay my tax. I do that and that. And when you see the result of smoking, and you want them to pity you, hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Adamic nature. One thing you cannot please in this life is your flesh. Because more will keep on coming. Ibaola introduce Galaxy 10, Galaxy 9, I think 9 will be 10.
10.
Another one is coming now. I note Galaxy Note 9 or 10 was introduced last year. Another one will be introduced very soon. So if that is what you want, that is what you want. You want to use the latest phone. And you don't consider some other things. You don't consider your income. You don't consider what other things that needs money. There was a program on TV maybe last week, I think, about those who are on benefits and they are in debt. Someone does not work for about 20 years. And the family were in debt of 30-something thousand pounds. Why? Because they buy this publicly. Publicly washing machine, publicly this, and at the end of the day, they have more than they can shield, and they were unable to pay their debt because it sounds so cheap, £20 here, £10 here, £5 here, this pound here. Whereas you know it, this if the washing machine costs £100 retail sales in the market, because number one, your credit history has spoiled. Number two, you are lazy, you cannot work, provide for yourself, so you will not know how to manage that money. Then because you need it desperately, instead of you looking for fairly used one
that can be sold for £15. Even some can even give it away for £20. Even some can even say free on Gumtree, free bees. Can say free, come and eat free of charge. Then you enter there and they say, don't worry, you'll be paying £5 every week. You're going to pay for how many weeks? They will say year, they will say weeks.
Hallelujah.
They won't say year, they will say weeks. They will say that they can say that 57 weeks. So you began thinking, it's not much now. But before you know it, the washing machine that cost £100 retail price, you will end up paying £1,000. That's how it works. So they are in debt 30 something thousand pounds. How do they get into it? You cannot, Adamic nature, it will want you to want more. Want more. These are the weapons that Satan uses against us. Number two is work of flesh. I've mentioned it. So I won't waste time on that. Just write Galatians 5:19. The Bible says, and the work of flesh follow doors. He mentioned it. Fornication, adultery, stealing. Galatians 5:19. Just write it down because of time. The work of flesh. They are what your flesh desire. I cannot do without it. Some people, they can lie from now to tomorrow. And you say, it's not my fault, it's my weakness. Then if it's your weakness, if you don't do anything about it, then it's going to destroy you. Praise the Lord. The work of flesh is number two. Galatians 5:19. Just write it down. Number three is worldly materials. 1 Timothy 5:6. 1 John 2:15. Let's read 1 Timothy 5:6. And if someone can open 1 John 2:6. Sorry, 2:15. 1 Timothy 5:6. Worldly material. That's I think Paul said that this person has neglected him, has forsaken him because he loved worldly things. What he said was
1 Timothy.
Yes.
What?
5:6. 5:6. I don't think that's it. Okay. You don't. He said, but the widow who lives for pleasure is dead, even while she lives. He said, that is what Paul is admonishing about the widow. That if you are a widow, but you want, I pray that God will not let our spouse die prematurely. Mm-hmm. But I want to generalize this to everyone who wants to live for pleasure. If you see 1 John 2:15, you can read. Anyone who wants to live for pleasure, you are dying. As I said earlier, that you want to smoke because it's your human right. You want to smoke because you want to drink. You want to have whatever pleasure because it's your right. You don't want them to stop you. Yeah, because you find pleasure in it. Don't worry, you are killing yourself softly. 1 John 2:15.
Do not love this even world or the thing in it. If yes. You love the world, you do not have the love. Yes. On the Father in you.
Thank you. He said, do not love the world. Or, what does that mean? It does not say that you are not going to be prosperous. It does not say that you are not going to be rich. But what he's telling you is that don't get rich by all means. Wait for your time. That's what he's telling you. People, you will see people speeding. They will be passing by your side. They will overtake you. Then you will think they have gone far. And you will be sad because you think your journey is delayed. Let me tell you this truth. It's a truth about life. They are at the corner. Hallelujah. Is that somebody living in this building about an hour ago, and you think that person must have reached M1. But to your surprise, after the service, You get out of the building and you see the person standing at the front of the building. That is how life is most time. So he said, worldly materials. You want to have this. You want to have that. That is why most people. That's why most people dip their hands into unclean things.
May the Lord have mercy on us.
Amen.
If you observe those things, God, because it's a plan of God to make you successful in life, it's God's plan. And it is the only blessing that God gives that has no repercussion. I've lived in this life with my little age of mind. I've seen somebody who when he was not blessed, when he hasn't had a car to that call his own, it's okay. But the moment he struggle and buy a car, the next week the car, it was killed by that car. Hallelujah. But we are not going to be telling you those stories to scare you away, because we know that God wants you to have your own mortgage. He wants you to have your own car. He wants to have your own family. He wants to have peace of mind. But he wants you to have it in his own way. Come on. It's another thing for you to be saying that it's worldly thing, and you are depriving yourself those good things that God wants you to have. And it's another thing wanting to have those things in all means, by all means. Defeating the one that defeats you. These are the three major weapons that Satan used. I would have mentioned more, but it will be repetition. How can you overcome? Because that is where it's more important. How can you overcome? How can you defeat Satan? Praise the Lord. Some people think that it's by when you are fire. Hallelujah. But it's just as simple as ABC of our Lord Jesus Christ. But let me say, as simple as ABC or Holy Spirit ABC. Hallelujah. How can you overcome? How can you defeat the one that defeats you? Number one is just be vigilant. Akiyesi. 1 Peter 5:8 says, you've read it, it said, be vigilant. You must be paying money, or you can confess surely. Praise the Lord. Or you don't finish surely. Tell me, it got to be okay. The money, you're paying money. I see you. So, would you know, so goodbye. Oh, I'll be the same. I see you, but would you know, finish shocking? Say the guy, can you still be fencing it? But that eye is for. Is to see the very what is going on. Hallelujah. So be vigilant. Most people think that if you want to fight Satan, you must go into 700 days fasting. You must fast throughout your life. No. Christianity or serving God is not as word as most people present it. He said, be vigilant and be sober, because this your Satan, your enemies, is roaming about today, most especially in this country, it's almost all over the world. Christianity is being threatened. It's being threatened. About 2 weeks ago, Church of England said that intercourse should be in between male and female. And Church of England was backlash for that, for saying that, to the point whereby few days later they come to apologize to the community that are not agree. Hallelujah. Because Satan is roaming about, the church is condemned for not accommodating, but the world doesn't take it lightly when you go against what they want you to reduce or to relieve, to relegate yourself, your spiritual power, to accommodate them. But they are not understanding. That's why I support that preacher that says that sinners are welcome in the house of God, but they should not be made comfortable. Because if you pick up a contract and you sign up for the contract, they will not be lenient with you if you bring that contract. So if it is to their own, you bring their contract and you are fined.
to the point whereby they destroy your credit score, that you cannot acquire credit anymore. Now they want to come to the church and they want you to be lenient. You are sin, Akbele. Akbele, be growing in your sin. Be vigilant. As I said earlier, that we might our preaching might not be as conk, as raw, or let me say as conk as 20 years ago. But that does not mean that we should accommodate sin in among us. Which means that we are still going to say the same thing in a different way, and it will still carry the same fire as it carries, because the word of God is new and fresh every day. Number two, put on the armor of God. Ephesians 6:11. He said, put on the whole armor of God. That's what Paul advised. You cannot fight. Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
You are blessed in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He says, put on, fight the battle of God with God's weapon. Are you with me?
Yes, sir.
Are you there?
Yes.
Paul said, if you want to fight this battle, you can only use God's weapon. If the queen send you an errand, you are going there in the name of the queen, and you are using queen's whatever queen is provided. Back in a local town and village and city where we have king. There's something that is practiced in Nigeria or Africa. We have staff, royal staff. Whenever you see that staff, you automatically have the presence of the king. Either the king is there or not. So fight the battle of God with God's weapon. That's why Paul says, put on the armor of God. It is not, sometimes some people will be worried because they cannot pray for long. They will be worried because they cannot fast for long. But as we were told in Sunday school, you can do something else for longer than others. There are some preachers who are in the olden days who prayed. They all they do is to pray all their lives. And people like Charles Spurgeon, they were blessed in speaking the word of God. Even to the point where it was qualified that when Charles Spurgeon speak, they say that people's soul become dry grass, and the word from his mouth become fire, and it consumes their soul, and they are faithful for God. So what you need to do is say, God, this is what you bless me with, but guide me. Only matoju mi de over lai rola ye oshi, guide me, oh Lord, yeah. Pregriming, that's what, and so on and so forth. Hallelujah. It's God's battle. Let him lead you. Don't you just hide yourself inside. It's about you. So that Paul will not say, go to, if you are privileged to go to Bible school, if you are privileged to further, if you are privileged to read, but if you're not, if you're the kind that your brain doesn't go ahead, go along with reading, maybe you are good in watching movies, watching documentaries that the godly ones, just divert it. Maybe you are good in listening to messages. Just divert it. Instead of listening to worldly things, just divert your interest to what will bless your soul. Look for the new messages on the internet, on YouTube or whatever. Listen to them and let them bless your souls. But you think because you cannot fast and you cannot pray that you are powerless. No, because it is not your weapon. It is not your battle. Is the battle of God. Any soldier in any country, they don't go to war with their own weapon. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
The government of their country provided every weapon they needed, every armor they needed. So because it is not their battle, is the country's battle, is the government battle. So either they are helping someone or they are fighting the battle directly. So they are not buying guns, they are not buying ammo, and buying shoe, boots, and uniform with their own money. It should be provided because it is not their battle. The same thing, the life we are living, this Christian life, it is not our life, it's the life of God. So let us put on that armor of God. In the Lord bless us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I want to finish now, but I say about 2 or 3 months ago. The next one is wash and pray. Wash and pray. Only I want to share Bunshadu. Won't go Baba Watinja. Won't feel con weeping. Ma Shora. The first one says be vigilant. It's almost the same thing as wash and pray. Be vigilant means don't be. Don't ma surround. It's almost the same thing as wash. But what you need to add to it is how little you can pray. Hallelujah. Is how if it just for you to just say, God, I thank you for the grace. There are many examples in the Bible. One analogy that Jesus used is that Pharisee that at and tax collector that went to the temple. No, okay. O ma to stage kan awa ta ti pe ni gbagbo a ma fi gbere ka Olorun soro Olorun gba o but me listen very well. No, I come to church every Sunday. I did not take Sunday job, and the job is double pay. They offer me another work in Scotland. I did not go. Another one in Ghana. I did not go because of you. So listen very well. I'm not like those who are. That's how we pray. I remember then. I'm not like those who are on the streets drinking, smoking. They are there fornicating, misbehaving. You know, because of our rapport with God. Most times you come before God with arrogant hearts. But somebody knows that he is a sinner. He does not even have the charisma to move closer to the pulpit, to the altar. He knelt down far away. Which tells you that wherever you are, God can hear your prayer. Hallelujah. He said, God, have mercy on me. I'm a sinner. And Jesus said, God, that sinner goes home far more blessed because he prayed with humble hearts. Just simple prayer. Instead of you condemning yourself, just simple prayer. Instead of you kneeling yourself in the cross, just simple prayer. Jesus has been nailed to the cross. He has died for you. All he wants you to do is to accept him and just offer that simple prayer. Then fill you there for long. The next one, be filled with Holy Spirit. Act 4:8. Write it down. Be filled with Holy Spirit. Yes, Act 4:8. Can we read? Let's read. Let me fill with Holy Spirit. Act 4:8 says, and Peter, filled with Holy Spirit, and said to them, rulers and elders of the people, and so on and so forth. Peter, filled with Holy Spirit, and he speak. If you are filled with Holy Spirit, he will teach you what to say, and nobody will take offense. Are you with me?
Yes.
Yeah, because it's God's battle, it's God's word. Because your word will come fire, it's no longer your word, it's God's word. So let Holy Spirit fill inside you. The last but not the least, be a Bible student. Study your Bible very, very well. Luke chapter 4, 3, 5. Luke chapter 4, verses 3 to 5. I'm trying to make it snappy and powerful so that we will not
exhaust our time too much.
And the devil said unto him,
yes,
if thou be the Son of God,
mm-hmm,
command this stone that it may be bread.
Mm.
And Jesus said to him,
mm,
saying, mm-hmm, it is written,
yeah,
the man shall not live by the bread alone.
Thank you.
But it by is, every word of God.
You are blessed. It is written. You know, Satan will come. As I said, he will come. And he will come and say, why are you going to church? Your pastor cannot even run to miracle. Somebody, that person asked me, am I, he said, do you conduct deliverance in your church? He said, am I in church? Pastor, I said, yes. Do you conduct deliverance in your church? And I said, I'm sorry, I'm not a deliverance minister. But when need be, which means I've given, if you're looking for deliverance, you can come. But don't, if I'm not led by the Spirit of God, I may not be able to do anything. So it's only if I'm led by the Spirit of God. So I'm not a deliverance minister, but I'm not scared of devil. I'm not scared of Satan. Yes, that's why I said if need be. That is to give you an option. If you want to come, you are welcome. And if you say, okay, I really need a proper deliverance minister, good luck. Hallelujah. He said that that's Luke 3:4-5. Show them, yeah. Luke 4:3-5 says
3-5.
Yes, no, is that thank you, ma. Just don't let me thank you very much. I just want to recap. He said, it is written. Man does not, it is written. Devil will come. And somebody asked me when I was in Nigeria, then I said that Pastor, Ibolama Shibele. Ibele means be in the church for several days and be fasting and praying. She said, because that is when we used to see vision, I will prophesy.
Okay.
Yeah. And I said, when the Spirit of God leads me. Because I've had the news that was when the prophesy evil. After the belly, then somebody would die in the church. That was what, and I won't find it most fun. So now, because hallelujah, because the former pastor used to give them a belly, whatever. And he said, "You know, belly, am I? I'm so tell." And I said, "But she went badwalo. What tell them? Bani kashi belly." Then they want. I want to stop now. Then they wanted to. They wanted to use another means by prophesying. Then they prophesy. So within short period of time, that thus says the Lord come to pass, but none of them died. Then during the Thanksgiving of that family, the fact that family come to do Thanksgiving, I don't know what pushed that person. She just come out and say, yes, I said it and it almost come to pass. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Then that day I go before the Lord. God said, from now till I will be transferred from this church, if you want to speak, I don't want to hear, thus says the Lord, from any of these people. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
If you want me to exercise my authority as a minister of God, I will. I know to do it. God, from now henceforth, to the way you are going to be able to do it, but you are going to do it. To the way you are going to be able to do it, won so gbono mi wole ba ti e ni lo yi ti to ba gbun gbun mi so si to ba ma soro to ba soro atenu enu awon eyan yi mu de bo won da mo enu awon eyan yi mi o ni listening, which means it's not you talking. If you want to say anything, by thus says the Lord, speak through somebody else and to the glory of God. Won so pe ba iluwa yi mo ni kuro nbe ta ma ti e ma so o ma gbe mo kuro nbe ni through Elomi to get fresh it is enough time that you will be manipulated because it's what you enjoy most. This is how the end of the He is out to defeat us. So that is why Paul will say, I don't talk much about fasting and prayer. You see? Because it's not just about fasting and prayer. It is about those little things which we do not observe. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
That's why Paul says that be vigilant. Peter says, pray and watch. Have Holy Spirit. Understand what God says. Oh, God, oh, man, you will be come, come, naked, you must be one being a sinner, but my sister, oh, my, I don't walk back, won't be a sinner, but what you want, 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 God deliver me from the bondage of Satan. Begin to pray. Are you praying? Are you praying? We are going to pray. Deliver me, God, from the bondage of Satan in the name of Jesus.